10 decimeter cube of O2, 10 decimeter cube of O2 at 101.325 kilopascal. Kilopascal. 0.325 kilopascal and 298 Kelvin is heated to 348 Kelvin. Is heated to 348 Kelvin. 10 decimeter cube of oxygen O2 at 101.325 kilopascal and 298 Kelvin is heated to 348 Kelvin. Calculate the heat absorbed. Calculate the heat absorbed. Comma, delta H and delta U of the process. Heat absorbed, comma, delta H and delta U of this process at first question, constant volume. Constant volume and constant pressure. Constant volume and constant pressure. Cp is given for this.
What is it?
Cp is 25.72 plus 0.013. It's temperature.
Can we just add that?
Minus.
It's a function. It's an equation.
3.86 into 10 to the power minus 6.
T square.
So this is Cp. You need to find out heat at constant pressure and constant volume. See, first of all, wait, guys. Okay. We'll see one thing and then we'll solve this question. Just small thing with this. Okay. You see, the delta H enthalpy. It is defined as the heat content. Heat contained of the system at constant pressure. Heat contained of the system at constant pressure. See, two conditions we have: at constant volume. Stop talking, guys. Stop talking. Constant volume and at constant pressure. So for constant pressure, Cp value is given, right? Which we need. And for constant volume, what we need? Cv, which is not given in the question. Right? So first of all, we need to find out Cv to solve this question. Correct? Now, how to find out Cv? You see, heat content of the system at constant pressure, and then we can write it as dH is equals to dU plus pdV. Right? This we are writing down from the first law of thermodynamics, which is dQ is equals to dU plus dW, work done. Right? Constant pressure, if you take, this dW is nothing but we can write dU plus dP into V. Right? Because work done is pressure into volume. Further, we can write it as dU plus pdV plus VdV. okay, and this is nothing but dq. Now if you take the condition of constant pressure, because this is what we have at constant pressure, so this dq becomes what? dq becomes dh, and dp is equals to what? 0. So when I substitute this to here, dh is equals to du plus pd. This is the mathematical definition of enthalpy. Okay? Right. Now in this, you see, if I divide this by dt, this is by dt, and this is by dt. Okay? dh by dt is what? dh by dt is cp, and du by dt is cv, and this one is what?
R.
Right? This becomes cp minus cv is equals to R. This is the relation of cp and cv.
I think we did it in four.
CP is given, so we can find out CV here from this equation. Correct? This is one thing. Okay. Understood? Huh? Yeah, so what? Let's, we get CV also in the form, in the expression of temperature. Right? Now to solve this question, first of all we need to find out the number of moles, which is PV by RT. Right? Pressure, volume, R and temperature is given. Right? So this number of moles, if you substitute all the values, what is the value given?
So
101.32
kilopascals.
And volume is given 10 liter divided by R is 8.314 will take, and temperature is 298 initial. When you solve this, what is the N you are getting?
4 by 10.
So 0.4 you are getting, right? Approximately 0.4 you are getting. Okay? Now what we need to find out? At constant pressure, we need to find out delta H. So delta H is equals to what? dH is equals to what? And Cp dT. Right? And Cp is a function of temperature. That Cp will substitute here and will integrate this. Right? So dH is equals to nu, let it be. And Cp is nothing but 25.72.
So how do you integrate it? 3.42.
Just make it 50. Make it 50 and then use, no?
No, but what about 3.8?
Inside that, I put the square.
No,
neglect the 10 power minus 6 term.
What is the square with 50?
Neglect them. Cube is 10 power minus 6. It doesn't change anything.
Square is there.
Square.
And when you integrate this, what is the limit we have here?
298.
So this will be 25.72.
So 574.2
minus T1. 0.01352 T2 square minus T1 square.
No, yeah, that's not allowed. I just realized.
Okay.
Yeah.
And this becomes minus 3.86 4 minus.
No, but I think you can.
That's not.
600 approximately.
Okay.
Method you understood?
Yes, sir. Yeah.
You won't get this kind of expression in the exam. Okay, sir. Complex calculation nahi aayega. Okay, but you should know the method how to do it. Okay, so whenever the CP is given in terms of temperature, so we'll write down like this, integrate and substitute the value of temperature, you'll get the answer. Right? So answer this H, you'll get approximately around 604 or something. When you solve this, don't do it, let it be.
Sir, do you eyeball it and say 604?
No, I answer I have. Okay. Delta H on enthalpy is this. Method is this, right? Now, if you find out this delta U, then what we have to do? Delta H is equal to delta U plus P delta V. Right.
You have to find delta V also. Delta V is not
you.
No, for constant volume pressure.
Delta V we need to find out. Okay, we'll see one more thing then. Okay, see here. Delta H is equals to delta U plus P delta V we have. And P delta V we can also write it as delta NG RT. Delta NG RT, can we write this?
That's from states of matter.
NG.
Wait, I don't know if it is.
See, PV1.
Principle immersion said a suppose number of gaseous have products minus gaseous.
See, for a gaseous reaction.
I remember that.
That's in this.
For a gaseous reaction, what we'll write? PV1 is equals to N1RT. N1 is the number of moles of gaseous particles. PV2 is what? N2RT, number of moles of gaseous particles. Okay? So any reaction, if it is supposed given, like suppose I write down one reaction here, 3.
We didn't do it in
the same. I'll take an example later. So when you subtract this, left side we have P delta V, and here we'll get RT N2 minus N1 OA. Okay, this is for reaction. Like in this case, we are going to use this. So P delta V is nothing but work done minus of this. Minus of this is also the work done, so we'll multiply minus sign both sides. So what we can write, dW is equals to, or delta W is equals to, minus delta NG into RT, where this delta NG is equals to N2 minus N1. Can I write this? Delta NG, N1, N2 is the number of moles of only gaseous particles.
Right.
It depends on the reaction. No, we'll come to this question. But this is a general thing I'm giving you. Right? The concept that we have. So this we use the expression of work done, we use this when reaction is given. Okay, so you need to find out delta V into that. Right? So the expression, this delta H, this expression becomes what? Delta H is equals to delta U plus
minus delta.
Why P delta V is this only? Huh? So delta NG into RT. This is the another expression of delta H and delta U that we use when chemical reaction is given. We only take gaseous particles. Okay?
Yeah.
Right. Now, two more things you can understand here. See, work done is what? Work done delta W is equals to minus delta NG into RT. Okay? Now, if delta NG is less than 0, delta NG is less than 0, then work done is what?
Positive.
Greater than 0, positive. Positive means work done. Work done on the system.
Work done is positive means that there is contamination.
I'll tell you what happens. Work done on the system. Now, for example, you see delta NG less than 0. If I write this one, 3O2 gas, and it converts into 2O3. This reaction. So for this reaction, delta NG is what?
0.
N2, that is 2 minus this, which is less than 0. 2 minus 1. Understood this? The delta NG thing, it depends upon what reaction you have. ठीक है? That will ignore. We'll see that. Did you understand this? When chemical reactions is given, the delta W, we use this expression to solve the question. Like in this case, delta NG is this. Now suppose if I write down here, if delta NG is greater than 0, it means what? Delta NG greater than 0. It means work done is? Delta W is less than 0. Work done negative. It means what? Work done by the system. So just to find out delta NG, you can say whether work done by the system or on the system we have. For example, if I say this one. CaCO3. Solid, right? When it dissociates, it gives you what? CaO solid plus CO2 gas. Can you tell me delta NG for this one? This is one. This is solid. We ignore this. We ignore this. So one minus zero.
Oh yes, so this is like expansion because there's a gas being evolved.
Yes, yes, you can say that. The point is, with this delta NG, you can understand whether work done on the system or by the system. Number of so it is not a reaction, no. Delta T is given. It's not a reaction.
So
N R delta T. Got it? Because it's not, the reaction is not given in the question. Then W is equal to what? NR delta T. If reaction is given, then only we use this. Okay, delta NG. Okay. So these two conditions we write down, 1 and 2. By the gas we have already done. In this case, expansion, and in this case, contraction. Number of moles or this N value on the product side decreases, contraction decreases. Right on, next question. Calculate the work done. Right on, calculate the work done. When one mole of zinc when one mole of zinc dissolves in hydrochloric acid calculate the work done when one mole of zinc dissolves in hydrochloric acid at 273 Kelvin in an open vessel. Acyl is not one. Dissolves even, no? Zinc dissolves. Unit? Atmospheric liters. In joule, what we have to do? Always write down the answer in joules. Okay? Atmospheric liter means.
So, sir, 2,244.
Right, 2,244. Done. Open vessel we have, so pressure will be the atmospheric pressure. Pressure will be the atmospheric pressure. Just need to find out delta V. You see here the reaction is Zn with HCl. Wait. It gives you ZnCl2 plus H2 gas. Right? This is the only gas we have here. And if you see the condition, temperature is 273 Kelvin, pressure is 1 atmospheric. It means this is the condition of? Condition of STP, right? So 1 mole of H2 gas we are getting. So this gives you how, what is the volume here? 22.4 liter at STP. Right. So work done is what? Minus P delta V. Volume is given. Right. Pressure is 1 atmospheric. Okay, you can find out easily. The unit will be liter atm. And then you have to convert this into joule. Right. What is the volume initially we have?
So I'll do the.
So 1 into RT value you can substitute 8.314 into temperature. R if you substitute 8.314, directly you will get in joule. Right. So then in this case you don't have to convert this into liter atm. Pressure volume gives you liter atm. This gives you directly in joule. Okay? So that also is very important when you are using this expression. Right. So this comes in joule. Right. This also you have to take in joule.
So but this is not in joules.
No, you can buy R in joules. 0 to 8.314 if you take in joule. Delta NG is what? See, the point is, if you take it in liter atm, then also you can do. But if you have to find out this in joule, directly you put 8.314. Here directly you put 8.314. All these things you can take.